My God, it's full of stars.
All right, One Eye Jax here, and I, after watching the video a couple times, I realized that, you know, a lot of the people that are not fully versed in the language are not really going to know what's going on. So I decided to remake it and annotate it with the audio to explain what actually I'm showing you here. And I just wanted to mention that what we're going through here in this video is all these bizarre categories he's created. He's created categories of vehicles, he's created categories of coins, he's created categories of birds, he's created categories of crazy, all things crazy, loony, fruity, nutty. He's created, so he has all these bizarre categories. And he keeps repeating them, but he doesn't repeat 50 of them in one movie. He'll put a few in one movie, a few in the Apollo missions, a few in another movie. And it's when you watch all the movies from A to Z, you start noticing that, oh yeah, he's got the bird in that one too, and he's got a bird in this one, and you know, he's referencing a vehicle that's a horse, and so you make these lists, and after a while you realize that these things aren't accidental; they're being put there intentionally. And so when I say there's vehicles in the puzzle, and when I say there's coins in the puzzle, and there's birds in the puzzle, and there's crazy, you know, expressions for being crazy in the puzzle, and crazy people in the puzzle, that's what this video is about, to show you the repeating patterns of how he's communicating this. And some of them are very hidden, you know, some of the birds and some of the vehicles are very hidden, but they're there. And of course, we're always, a lot of times we're using Greek allegory, a lot of times we're using games allegory, you know, we're playing playing cards, or we're playing chess, or we're playing ping pong, or we're playing, there's a million different ways to interpret what you're finding. So when you find Wayne Newton, King of Vegas, and Anne Margaret, Queen of Vegas, you just made a pair there, you have a King and Queen of Vegas. So in that case, you're playing cards. But in other cases, you're not playing cards. When you're playing Roman ping pong, which is birthday, death day, for these Jungian archetypes, you know, it's a different game. It's ping pong. When you're playing slices, you know, you can have a slice in golf, you can have a slice in tennis, you can have a slice in ping pong, you can have a slice of apple, a slice of lemon, a slice of lime, a slice of orange, clockwork orange. You can have a slice of the azimuth equidistant map. You can have a slice of the UN map. You can have a slice of cherry pie in Twin Peaks. You know, you can have a slice from Jax Collins' axe with the eagle beak. So he's using these bizarre synchronicities like slice to tie these things together. So you're chopping, you're cutting, you're slicing. You have the Captain America chopper. You have the Bell Jet Ranger chopper that we see the shadow of at the beginning of The Shining. A heliocopter. It's based on the word helios, which is the sun. And it's the going to the sun road. So Danny wears the Apollo sweater. It's the going to the sun road. It's a helioscopter. So that's what we're going to go through in this video. And I'm going to add more new stuff on the end of it. So if you've already seen the other video, you're going to learn new stuff anyway. So, and the first part of this is going to be a way to explain that this is a monolithic message. This is not just Kubrick. This language is being used by other directors in other movies, and they were being used before Kubrick.
Slaves you were, and slaves you remain.
And they're being used
but
now.
The terrible penalty of crucifixion.
So this
has been
scene,
set aside.
They're told they have to point out which prisoner is Spartacus. And since they've all fought with Spartacus, and they all realize, you know, what the consequences are, and they'd rather all die than give up one man. So this is Hollywood. And Hollywood is Spartacus. So Kirk Douglas is the first cuckoo bird. He buys the rights to the story. He sells them to his son or gives them to his son. His son makes One Flew Over the Cuckoo's Nest. So Kirk Douglas is intrinsically linked to One Flew Over the Cuckoo's Nest. He's the first McCready. He's the first McMurphy. So they all go, I am Spartacus, and they stand up. This is how we have to address the problem we have in the world. Everyone has to pull their own weight. So we go from there right to a scene in The Shining. And all you need to do in this scene is listen to the Roadrunner theme. That's one of the clues. Of course, you know, in the back here, we have the, you got Winnie the Pooh and the baseball bat, but and the chocolate milk and the cereal. But the main thing you're getting here is the Roadrunner. It's a bird, and it's in the cuckoo family. And it turns out it's New Mexico state bird. So Kubrick is giving you birds, but he's also giving you states when he gives you birds. And we know this because we see, oh, this is Bill McNeil's picture. If you're watching the video and you haven't looked at that picture for half an hour, you need to pause it there and look at it. And that's all things Jack. Then we have Johnson, paste, wax, and feathers. So this is Icarus's wax and feathers. Icarus could fly, so he's a bird. There's the falcon feather from Apollo 15 laying on the ground. There's the Apollo 15 falcon feather hammer drop. There's wings, Paul McCartney's band Wings. So we're doing birds and flying and wings and flight. And One Flew Over the Cuckoo's Nest. That's a cuckoo clock. There's a cuckoo. They actually mimic the markings of a falcon to keep birds away. And then we have the cuckoo again. Kirk Douglas. First, McMurphy.
Jack, there's someone else in the hotel with us. There's a crazy woman in one of the rooms. She tried to strangle Danny.
Are you out of your fucking
mind? So he says, are you out of your fucking mind? It's another expression for you crazy. Are you cuckoo? Are you nutty? Are you fruity? Are you missing a few of your blue marbles? The screws are loose. There's a million different expressions for you're crazy. You know, shine on your crazy diamond. So it's another repeating theme. He has a theme of expressions for you're crazy, you're nutty, you're loony. And the derivations of the words themselves, loony and lunatics and Looney Tunes, all come from Luna, the moon. So he's giving you the moon.
I'm just gonna go and talk to
the
Dan
fact
for
that,
a few minutes.
You know, he's keep repeating this theme, you're crazy,
right
over and over and over.
Now I want you to just stay here and watch your cartoons, okay?
So here we are at the Overlook, and we have a blue Roadrunner in the parking lot. And the maze entrance changes position. So there's a plum crazy purple Roadrunner. We get the plum from Jack Spratt. We're using nursery rhymes as well. So all things Jack has Jack Spratt in it. We have the clock, slice of clockwork orange, the cuckoo clockwork orange, the slice in golf, the slice in tennis, the slice in ping pong, clementine mission, meadowlark lemon, slice of apple, Newton's apple, the jack-o'-lantern, lime, slice of lime, the superbird, the plum crazy purple Roadrunner, the plum, the cow jumped over the moon, the slice bread, I can't even keep up with it, the slice of, so it's all slices, chopping, cutting, slicing.
Unfortunately, as soon as the step, I can't do it with two hands, but I'm going to try a little sand trap shot here.
You can hear the cuckoo bird. So it's a Jungian archetype. He has the longest drive on the moon, the longest golf shot ever on the moon.
like a slave to me, Al.
So the season runs from October 31st for Jack, which is Halloween Day. And I look like a slice to me, too. So here's another slice. There's a slice from Twin Peaks, the slice of cherry pie, whatever white bread. You have a slice of white bread. This is the longest golf drive ever on the moon. One only, first, last, only. Guinness Book of World Records. So we're doing slices.
There we go.
There's a slice of orange, clockwork orange. Slice of tennis, Billie Jean King. Slice of juicy fruit. Hong Kong food, chopped everything up with this karate chop. Whatever white bread slice. Ketchup on the rye bread slice. The lemon from Gus Grissom slice. There's the human, the bird. There's Nicholson throwing the tennis ball. The jackknife beetle, the jackknife, the buck jackknife, the sliced up Brady twins, the sliced up lemon, the slice of UN flag, slice of AE azimuthal equidistant, the slice of the Tycho magnetic anomaly, slice of orange, slice of bread knife, burnt toast, rye bread. You know, they're all linked together.
I suppose they told you anything in Denver about the tragedy we had up here during the winter? Denver about the tragedy?
The Greek tragedy we had up here during the winter
of 1970?
I don't believe they did.
Jack clearly knows about this story already.
Did.
Well, my predecessor in this job hired a man named Charles Grady as the winter caretaker. And he came up here with his wife.
So this is Polanski.
About 8 and 10. And he had a good employment record. Good references.
So we have a bronze. There's a bronze eagle behind his head, and there's a bronze eagle on the left-hand side. So he's got double bronze eagles. The curtains behind his head are theater curtains. So Apollo was a theater. Ford's is a theater. Kennedy's is a theater.
But at some point during the winter,
he went crazy. Loony, nutty, fruity. This man is crazy as a March hare. And we hear the loons, which you probably can't even hear. But. So chapters 11 and 12, they play the loons right at the beginning of it. They live on the side of a volcano. There's no loons living on the side of a volcano above the tree line. You can hear them there. So there's a loon. That's what they look like. They always have. There's always a pair of loons. We're always making
some
pairs.
During the winter, he must have suffered some kind of a complete mental breakdown. He ran amok and mental breakdown.
He's a lunatic. There's the cuckoo clock. There's another cuckoo. There's the loon. There's Luna.
Have a complete mental break. He killed his family with an axe. Kubrick viewed his movies as his children.
He chopped his children up with an axe. His children were his movies. Even though when they were done, they were still part of the family.
In one of the rooms of the West Wing.
He created these clips through all his movies that tie together, whether they're linked together by a bird, or whether it's a vehicle, or it's a famous junkie on his birthday or death day. He put both barrels of whiskey, single barrel whiskey. So all these things are woven together through clever usage of language.
Killed his family.
So he chopped them up. Stacked them neatly. This is what he
I thought that it was what the old timers used to call
cabin fever. There's your cabin fever. Log cabin fever. We see Lucas Porter carrying logs. We see references to Lincoln killing. He's born in a log cabin. You have the games, Lincoln Logs, the little kids' game.
There's
the Laurel Canyon log. There's the logs with the Playboy models in them. And of course, April 15th is Lincoln's death day. The Donners depart Lincoln on April 15th. The Titanic sinks April 15th. It's IRS tax day. Your money's no good here. Orders from the house.
Well, that sounds fine to me.
Jack's
well,
response to this is ridiculous. He just says, well, that's fine. That's fine. Yeah,
well, that sounds fine to me.
You know, the guy diced up his entire family. Oh, that's fine. So, of course, he breaks the fourth wall, blinks his eyes, and we have the shown clue.
They'll love it.
So here we have Scatman telling you that Stanley's a genius and that he cuts all his flicks and he's a genius with his tricks.
He's a writer, he directs. He's a writer, he directs. He produces his projects. He's the man behind the lens. And Stanley always wins. He's the man who looks ahead, can make you think he raised the dead. He's the man who looks ahead, can
so he can make you think he raised the dead.
He's the man who looks ahead, can make you think he raised the dead. Edison cuts all his flicks. He's a genius with his tricks. He does it all. Shoom ding doo. Edison cuts all his flicks. He's a genius with his tricks. He does it all. Shoom ding doo. Shoom ding doo. Shoom ding doo. He does it all. Shoom ding doo.
So he does it all. Cuts all his flicks.
And I'll drop the two of them here.
So here we have some more birds. This is the Falcon Lem. And James Irwin, who's in this mission, is a real-life falconer. So he has his own falcon. And, of course, he's dropping the falcon feather and the hammer. A proof of gravity, the 1/6 gravity on the moon. So this is Kubrick telling you that the whole gravity thing is a crock of shit. And, you know, you got the, it's a triplet. You have the Falcon Lem, the Falcon Feather, and, you know, James Irwin is a falconer. So the triple falcon right there. So they do this thing, and clearly, you know, I don't know, we're doing a slow-mo, we're waiting. It's so easy to fake this thing. And you can see the feather is, like, moving before he even does it. You know, you got Newton's apple. The GP, so he's testing things in gravity fields, and you have Newton's apple, Wayne Newton, king of Vegas.
It's a huge shit sandwich, and we're all going to have to take a bite.
Sir, does this mean that Anne Margaret's not coming?
Anne Margaret is queen of Vegas. Wayne Newton is king of Vegas. So you just made a pair. Clue, you're looking for
three lipsticks, three pair of nylon stockings. Shoot, a fella could have a pretty good weekend.
So Dallas has changed to Vegas because Kennedy's killing. That movie comes out on his birthday. So that's your Vegas-Dallas clue. So there's the Apple records. Instant Karma is the inspiration
so we thought we'd try it here for you.
The book, The Shining.
The feather happens to be appropriately a falcon feather.
So it's a falcon
Appropriately a falcon feather. Appropriately a falcon feather.
Because they're riding a falcon.
Falcon.
So it's a bird. So then you have the Masonic Double Eagle. There's James Irwin, this falcon. The Apollo Eagle, a double eagle in golf. The Stovington Eagles. The bird is the word. You have the Adler Eagle typewriter. You have Eagle Productions is the name of the production company for the making of The Shining. You have Peregrine Productions. You have Hawk Productions. I mean, it's ridiculous how many birds he's, you know. Then you have James Forrestal and the Nightingale. Well, these are the loons again here. We have loons, the falcon. There's the Unisphere. There's Unibrow. Unibody, Unisphere, Unicorn, Cuckoo. A cuckoo mimics the falcon.
I'll drop the two of them here, and hopefully they'll hit the ground at the same time.
So is that a cuckoo feather or a falcon feather?
And hopefully they'll hit the ground at the same time.
And of course, this all ties right back into Icarus and his wax and feathers and, you know, Kubrick's Icarus speech and don't fly too hard, tie too close to Apollo's sun. So there was a reference to the Millennium Falcon. Pictures with 1,000 words. And we have the Millennium Falcon and the Grand Overlook. And the, you know, the 1,000-yard stare. It's always 1,000. A picture's worth 1,000 words. So we hear the cuckoo again. You know, it's near the threshold of perception, but you can hear the cuckoo.
Superb.
And the other thing I want to mention is these. I love these announcers they have on there. They're all like complete hicks, like, get the ATB and put it on the 427, Billy. You know, it just sounds so asinine when you're watching this. This guy, when he goes, oh, here, good job there. Or when he does the falcon feather drop, the guy's like, good job, bull. You know, it's like, really? I mean, this is where the billions went? I mean, did you hire these people in Arkansas? I mean, come on. So there's the cuckoo. He mimics the falcon in his markings. So, yeah. So this is Scatman who dies November 22nd, the day Kennedy dies. So he's a direct ping pong match for Kennedy. It's a death November 22nd. And here he is telling you he's a genius with his tricks, and he cuts all his flicks. Yeah, he looks ahead, he can make you think. So he's the guy that has the smoking gun pipe playing the piano in the Overlook Lodge. And he had the smoking gun pipe. Here's Kennedy again.
He killed his family with an axe.
So he chopped him up.
He's a genius with his tricks. He does it all. Shoom ding dong. Edison cuts all his flicks. He's a genius with his tricks. He does it all. Shoom ding dong. Shoom ding dong. Shoom ding dong. He does it all.
So Hong Kong Fooey is voiced by Scatman. He chops with his cry chop. They've been chopped with the axe. She's got the bread knife. You got a slice. He's got the Collins axe with the eagle beak, the slices, the slices, the slices, the slices, 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 slice of orange, slice of pie, slice of tennis, slice of golf, slice of rye bread, slice of burnt toast, slice of white bread, slice of apple, slice of lemon, slice of ping pong, slice of tennis. So, you know, you get the idea. He's repeating these bizarre synchronicities between these categories. And this is how we weave them together. You know, tennis is a ball. Tennis, you can have a slice. Billie Jean King is a tennis ace. If you take a king and you add it to an ace, you know, we're playing cards again. You got 21. All right, you got the Playboy Bunny, Miss Scott. Scott is a clue set. Robert Falcon Scott, George G. Scott, Randolph Scott. We have the cards. We just got a guy. If you notice, when he shuffles the cards, he's got all the face cards in one hand and all the number cards in the other when he shuffles them. There it is again. Face cards are on the left. You got One-Eyed Jack's the movie. It's slang term for a Jack of Spades, a Jack of Hearts. The One-Eyed Jack Bunny.
I know you think this is crazy, but I just got a message from Bates over the CRM 114.
We got another reference to crazy.
I know you think this is crazy, but I just got a message from Bates over the CRM 114.
Loony,
I know you
nutty,
think this is crazy,
fruity.
But I just got a message from Bates over the CRM 114. He called his wing at Jack Flanard. Alfa Romeo. Movie? Did you say Wing Attack Plan
Goldie
R?
Is his name.
Yes, sir, I have. Yes, sir, I have. Goldie, how many times have I told you guys that I don't want no horsing around on the airplane? Goldie,
you got
how many
horsing
times
around.
Have I told you guys that I don't want no horsing around on the airplane?
You got Red Rum, three-time Grand National Champion, dies on Arliss Howard's birthday. Also, Lee Harvey Oswald's birthday. There's the sliced up. Now, if you notice, they're polar opposites in this picture. One's face up, one's face down, one faces right, one faces left. You got the Corona Borealis shaped like a horseshoe. You got Red Room, dies the day Lee Harvey Oswald's born. You got the horseshoe on the wall, all the way to the right in the top, when the phone goes out. You got Blackjack Kennedy's ride of this horse, horse and train photograph, or horse and train picture by Colville.
Sure's a nice day, ain't it?
So this is Tim Carey in Kubrick's movie The Killing.
When I first got up this morning, but it turned out real fine. Kind of funny when you stop to look at it. Well, it's almost the same as it always is this time of year, but I sure appreciate the way you treated me, mister. Well, it's not so much the money. Of course, I appreciate that too, but it's more the way.
I get it.
No, sir. I don't reckon I'll
So you got the horseshoe. He's trying to give him a horseshoe.
I brought you some luck.
Good luck.
Mister. You bet in this race, I figure you might need it.
Oh, now look, keep your junk in there, will you?
Some. Keep your junk in there, will you? Some.
Yeah, the Corona Borealis shaped like a horseshoe. The Minotaur myth is intimately linked to it. The Shea Stadium something shaped wrong? Like a horseshoe. It's nicknamed
you're
the horseshoe.
Wrong, nigga.
It's in Corona, Flushing, Queens.
Be a nice guy and go on about your business.
So here we have the cracker comment.
Sure, bones. Side to bar.
So anytime we see a cracker comment from a white guy, we need to look carefully. You know, you remember Grady says he calls Scatman a nigger cook in The Shining. So when we hear any kind of cracker comments, we need to look very carefully. That one right there is a cracker comment. So you got racehorses again and a racetrack, and they're thoroughbred. So Kennedy is a thoroughbred, and he needed to be taken out. So they hired a gunman, and they shot him as he rounded the corner on Elm Street. I mean, the parallels are ridiculous. We also have a horse named Stopwatch in this, not in this scene, but in the earlier. So we have a horse named after a watch. We've got a red rum, which is a liquor. So Tim Carey shoots Red Rum, the horse. It's on the Beatles album, a picture of him from that movie shooting the horse Red Rum. And you don't see it on the album itself, because Lennon is blocking it. So he's got a Morgan convertible, a handmade car with a wooden frame. Gets shot getting out of the vehicle. Murray Cooper said the hardest
Nicky
part
was
getting
dead
out of
at 4:24.
And of course, he's got a flat tire. The horseshoe punctured his tire and gave him a flat.
I think that was farther west in the Sierras.
What was the Donner Party?
So the Donner Party.
They were a party of settlers in covered wagon times. They got snowbound
covered
one winter
wagon
in the mountains.
Times.
They had to resort Snowball. To cannibalism in order to stay alive.
Cannibalism. So we have the planet Saturn in the book. It's Saturn. In the movie, it's Jupiter in 2001. You have the Alive book mentioned in Stephen King's book, The Shining, about the cannibalism. If Saturn ate all his children, he carries a sickle.
I will motivate you, Private Pyle, if it short dicks every cannibal on the Congo! Every cannibal on the Congo.
We're getting this theme of cannibalism repeated over and over. So there's Saturn eating his children at birth. The god of time carries the sickle, also known as Death, the Grim Reaper. Thoth. We see Thoth in Eyes Wide Shut at the end. He takes the woman that volunteers to sacrifice. Thoth, the Thoth mask character, takes her away. So that represents Saturn in his sickle. He's the god of time.
Saw it on the television.
Hey, wasn't it around here that the Donner Party got snowbound?
I think that was farther west in the Sierras.
Grady becomes snowbound and goes crazy and chops his family up.
They were a party of settlers in covered wagon times.
What was the Donner Party?
Covered wagon times.
They were a party of settlers in covered wagon times. They got snowbound one winter in the mountains. They had to resort to cannibalism in order to stay alive.
You mean they ate each other up?
They had to.
Oh, yeah. So here's the Apollo 1 crew praying that they live through the mission. And here they are again and doing a PR shot. And there they are, burned up inside their Apollo 1 capsule with the two doors that one opens inward. That's what remains of them. They burned up to cinders, essentially, inside the capsule. There's the remains of the Donner Party. They were told by a foolish politician there was a shortcut to California. There was no shortcut. There's their tracks in the Great Salt Flat, one of the flattest places in the world.
They were a party of settlers in covered wagon times.
So we're being clued into covered wagon times. So Kennedy's flag, covered wagon times. So we have Kennedy's wagon, we have the Donner Party, you know, spurned on by a foolish politician. We have Kennedy saying that we choose to go to the moon. And meanwhile, no one was, he knew he wasn't going to the moon. It was all a PR stunt. So there's the tracks from the Donner Party. Even hundreds of years later, the tracks are still there, unlike the proof we landed on the moon. There doesn't appear to be any proof. There's the Donner Wagon, so it's covered wagon times, the Donner Party. There's Blackjack, the riderless horse, the one Colville paints. So the message here is, if it's a true story, there will be evidence that really happened, like the Donner Party. And yet, with the moon missions, we don't see any real evidence. They're lying in polar opposite positions. One's north, one's south, one's face up, one's face down. There's Blackjack, the riderless horse with the boot and the stirrup. There's Little Brian, he gets crushed by the gift horse. So there's the Mustang and the Falcon, first unibody cars. Their debut at April 18th, the opening day of the World's Fair, is the first. If you look for the birthday of the Mustang, it's April 18th, the opening day of 1964 World's Fair.
Well, I've been to one World Fair, a picnic and a rodeo, and that's the stupidest thing I ever heard come over a set of earphones.
So the World's Fair, there's the Unisphere. We see that at the World's Fair for the first time. It's a Mercator projection. The orbits around it represent the Explorer satellites that we launched. There's the elevator system at the World's Fair. There's the first Bell videophone we ever get to see. The first, and you know, it's always the Jungian first. So here it is at the World's Fair, and they're using the first Bell videophone. We get to see the Apollo hardware for the first time at the World's Fair. So we see the Thor and Titan missile. We see the Apollo LEM and the CSM and the Saturn V rocket. There's the Unisphere. The Ford Mustang debuts April 18th, Arliss Howard's birthday. Redrum's death day. So here Dr. Floyd has to make a phone call. You notice the Bell logo right on the side of the wall. So it's a Bell telephone videophone. So we're being told we're looking for a Bell telephone videophone. The first one we ever see is at the World's Fair. So he turns this Dr. Floyd, his real name is William Sylvester, a Looney Tunes character. And it's a Bell, you can see the Bell logo on the screen as he types in his password or whatever. We see real parallax of the Earth out the window because the orbiting station is spinning. Hello. So we see the Earth isn't always in the same position because he's not in the center of the circle. He's on the outside. So here's Vivian Kubrick. He calls her Squirt. So we have the same theme of cream pie, squirt, head. You know, there's all these sexual connotations hidden below the subliminal layer.
I'm sorry, sweetheart, but I can't.
You know, so Daddy's not going to be home for her birthday.
Very sorry about it, but I just can't. I'm going to send you a very nice present, though. Anything special that you want? What?
So she wants an AT&T Bell telephone, but she wants a portable one. We know that, because she has a home one already.
We've got lots of telephones already.
So there's the Bell video telephone. The first one we ever see is at the World's Fair. And everyone, you know, makes calls on it, and they love it.
Can't you think of anything else you want for your birthday? Something very special?
So a bush baby is a little monkey. So we have Major King Kong. King Kong is the largest monkey ever. We have a barrel of monkeys. You know, we have the double barrel shotgun, the double barrel whiskey, the barrel of monkeys. It's a game.
That I'll try to telephone again tomorrow. Now, will you tell her that?
Yes.
Okay, sweetheart. Now have a nice birthday tomorrow.
So it's a birthday clue. Nice birthday. We're looking for junkie and famous too, people's birthdays. Now, Vivian Kubrick is born the same day that Neil Armstrong is, the 217th day of the year.
Bye-bye.
Neil Armstrong dies the 237th day of the year. So you have room 217, room 237. Now they all of a sudden make you have the Liberty Bell capsule. This is the capsule that Gus Grissom splashes down in, and it promptly starts to sink, and he almost drowns in it. And he uses the explosive bolts to get out of the capsule. So here's the capsule. It's just about to sink. He fires off the explosive bolts and swims to the surface. So they tried to kill him. That was the first mission they tried to kill Gus Grissom in. They were unsuccessful. All right, here we have the Molly Brown capsule. So you have Doc Brown, Molly Brown, Charlie Brown capsule, Snoopy capsule, Garrett Brown in the Steadicam, a brown stain on the mattress, and So we have this repeating color theme. The Titanic is a twin ship. You know, they're almost identical twins. Molly Brown survives. Since Gus Grissom almost drowned in his capsule, they named the next one the Molly Brown. There's the Titanic twins. Almost identical, but not exactly. Just like the Burns twin. Here we have doppelgangers, twins. There's the Arbus twins. Paul and Fall were twins, doubles. In the book, they're sisters. In the movie, they're the Burns twins. There's Diane Arbus. She takes the famous twins photos where you see Jungian opposites in the photos. There's the old lady in the bathtub, and you have Diane Arbus, the young woman who dies in the bathtub. Paul and Fall, they're doubles, twins, palindromes. Here's the first movie Kubrick does, Day of the Fight. This is Walter Cartier and his twin brother. One fights, one doesn't. They're Jungian opposites. Day of the Fight, Stanley Kubrick. There's the Twin Towers, two towers. We have the snowball fight in The Shining. We have Snowball in Full Metal Jacket. We're making pairs and twins, so we get a snowball fight and a snowball. We got the twin ships. In Eyes Wide Shut, Ziegler says, Tom Cruise says, what is it? There's the single, so two towers become one tower. Twin pines become the lone pine. This is the Arbus twins. You see, there's one not smiling, one smiling. They're Jungian opposites. You have the twin boilers in the movie. It was one boiler in the book. Apollo and Artemis are twins. She's the huntress. You know, here's the Burns twins. They were not twins in the book. They were sisters. So he changes it to twins. So you have the Terminator is the farthest you can see on a flat plane. Here's Johnny Malkovich. I love this guy. And you got the Gemini twins, you know, the Gemini program for Apollo. You got Jack throws the tennis ball, and we have the Gollywog doll right here. And right later in the movie, this is exactly where Scatman dies. So Scatman's twin is the Gollywog. You have the twin Burns twins lying in polar opposite positions, just like the North Pole and the South Pole. Twin Peaks, the movie with the big saw at the beginning of it. We're cutting, we're clipping, we're chopping, we're cutting. There's the Gemini twins. This is Gus Grissom. And here we have, you know, so he's imitating Admiral Byrd, and he's imitating Mick Jagger, and they were both taken by Diane Arbus. Yeah, there's the Gollywog, there's the Scatman. So the Gollywog and Scatman form a pair, a very bizarre pair. It's a racist pair. We're looking for a racist expression for a black man. And it's as black as the Ace of Spades, because he's the Ace of Spades, and Kennedy is the Jack of Spades for Blackjack. Molly Brown, the unsinkable Molly Brown, the Titanic. So we're using colors. You know, we have the Molly Brown capsule, Gus Grissom, and John Young. So we have Carl Young and the whole categories of Youngs. Twin Pines, Lone Pines, the 9/11 on the clock. So here's the movie, The Titanic, and this is Molly Brown. Very famous woman. Twin Peaks, you know. Twin Peaks is a slang expression for two aces in cards. Here's Vivian Kubrick. She gets her Bell video phone call. Here's the first Bell video phone ever used in the World's Fair, 1964 World's Fair. Here's a Bell Jet Ranger. So Gus Grissom flies in the Liberty Bell. Here's the shadow of the Jet Ranger, Bell Jet Ranger. And we have Rangers in the puzzle. I mean, we have the Lone Ranger. We have the Liberty Bell capsule. And it's always a seven, you know. Here we have Wendy, the Bell telephone went out in the horseshoe we see here. The Corona Borealis is shaped like a horseshoe. This is the crown of the princess is thrown to the sky. Here's Shea Stadium, nicknamed the horseshoe. Here's the horseshoe on the wall. So here's the Unisphere that we see at the 1964 World's Fair. This is the Mercator projection. And these two rings that go around are Explorer 1 and Explorer 2 satellites. So this is the first time we see... Okay. Let's watch this. So this is Cowboy. He's born the same day as Red Room and Lee Harvey Oswald. So he gets shot by the sniper. So in the background we have a depiction of, you know, it, allegorically it represents the monolith. The monolith is on fire. I mean, people are figuring this stuff out. You know, the globe Earth is falling away. And so Arliss, Art Howard is a cowboy. So you have Ron Howard, Arliss Howard, Kevin Major Howard, Howard Dean Stanton. Hang on, there's a whole category of Howards. Cowboy can hack it. So the entire puzzle, we have horses and Spur Crater and Saddle Rock and Blackjack. And we have the lens flares, of course. Always the lens flares. And of course the combat correspondent theme. So you have Jerome Salinger, combat correspondent. Alex Colville, combat correspondent. Rafter Man, which is a 2-4 in cards, combat correspondent. And of course, Matthew Modine, the Joker, a direct reference to a card. He's a combat correspondent. You know, he even says it in the movie. Are you a photographer? No, I'm a combat correspondent. So he's giving you the category of combat correspondent. So he can hack it. He's cowboy. So everything associated with a cowboy would be a bull riding, a cowboy hat, like Slim Pickin, the ex-matador, ex-rodeo clown who rides the bull bomb. We have, there's a picture of Slim Pickens when he was a matador. He was a bull slayer. Gary Lockwood is in a movie with Elvis, and so is Anne Margaret. There's Slim jumping a wagon with his horse. He was quite the horseman. Here he is bullfighting, Slim Pickens. Here he is as a cowboy. Slim was a real cowboy. I mean, he didn't have to come to the studio acting as a cowboy. He was a real cowboy. Here's the labyrinth. This represents Theseus in the labyrinth. So here he is a cowboy, so he can hack it. So we're doing all things cowboy, horse, you know, bull slayer, matador. So here he is half man, half bull. Half man, half bull. So it's half man, half bull. It's the Minotaur. You know, we have Kubrick's Minotaur Productions is the production company for the movie The Killing. And here we have the dartboard. It has one bullseye. And we see the Colorado flag with a slice out of it in the back. There's Minotaur Productions. This is A Killer's Kiss. I don't have this movie. I wish I did. There's the Colorado flag in the background. Of course, remember this hidden mirroring in those pictures in the background. Here's Theseus holding the magic thread and the Minotaur. Here's Theseus and the Minotaur slaying the Minotaur. Here's Danny walking backwards in his own footprints, just like Theseus did. He followed the magic thread. Kubrick tells us in interviews that Jack represents the Minotaur, Danny represents Theseus. You know, it's a labyrinth, and we're imprisoned in a labyrinth. Here's the Minotaur in the labyrinth, Jack in the maze. Here's the Killer Kiss. It's a Minotaur production. You know, so he's hitting you over the head with a sledgehammer with a Minotaur production. We're weaving in these magic threads together, and the threads he's left like Hansel and Gretel breadcrumbs, rye breadcrumbs, that is.
AJ Kong, message and base confirmed.
Well, boys, I reckon this is it. Nuclear combat toe-to-toe with the Ruskies.
I love that. Nuclear combat!
Like two civilized people.
So toe-to-toe with the Ruskies is a boxing reference.
All right,
do you want to die standing up or sitting down?
I
want to
die like a champion.
Or sitting down?
I want to die like a champion.
So this is Peter Sellers doing Stanley Kubrick, and actually doing a pretty good job of it. His mannerisms are similar. He's got the voice inflection down, the New York, the very relaxed New York accent he had. So here's all the boxers in our puzzle. We have Tony Burton, a real pro heavyweight boxer. Here's Tony Burton and Apollo Creed, Carl Weathers. You know, here's Teddy Roosevelt. He lost sight in one of his eyes. He was a boxer. Here's John Malkovich in his movie Color Me Kubrick with a boxer dog t-shirt on. So we're using dogs in this puzzle. So here's a boxer dog. We have the Moon Rover is a dog. So a moon dog, a sun dog. Apollo 14, Alan Shepard, which is a dog breed, a German Shepherd. You got Rocky, Sylvester Stallone. Sylvester is a Looney Tune. Jack Johnson. He's got two first names that are Jack. Jack and Johnson. You've got...
Gentlemen, step this way, please.
Jack Dempsey. So you got the Jack Russell Terrier. Here's Barry Lyndon.
Both shake hands. Shake hands. Take your stance. No biting, kicking, or scratching. The last man.
Well, boys, I reckon this is it. Nuclear combat toe-to-toe with the Ruskies.
So we're doing boxing here. Here's the boxer dog.
What's the deal, John? I want to die like a champion.
So that's Kubrick telling you that he wants to die like a champion. It's not, it's how you played the game. Here's James Forrestal, a boxer. There's the boxer t-shirt, Color Me Kubrick, Johnny Malkovich.
Take your stance. No biting, kicking, or scratching.
There's Sylvester Stallone and Rocky. So we go to Rocky with Garrett Brown in a Steadicam. The vehicle is the Steadicam. Here's Johnny Carson on The Carson Show with some boxing gloves. That was a picture of Johnny Carson I flashed on too quick. Johnny Carson was a real-life amateur boxer. There it is. Johnny Carson is a boxer. So we have a category of people that you may not know are boxers. Johnny Carson, the boxer. So he's the king of late nights, and he's Jack Carson. So he's a jack and a king. There's a boxer dog. So you got Frank Swingpool, ex-bull rider who knew Slim Pickens, who was a bull slayer. Here he is in the centrifuge, and he's Jungian shadow boxing with his jabs, you know. So there's a theme of boxing and boxing terms and boxers. Here's Tony Burton, professional heavyweight boxer with the rank of Duke. He plays Duke in Rocky. A Duke is also, like, you can have a king, a queen, a Duke.
What? What's that? Are you Quilty? No, I'm Spartacus. You come to free the slaves or something? Are you Quilty? No, I'm Spartacus.
We're weaving.
You come to free the slaves or something? Are you Quilty?
So he's doing Stanley Kubrick in that scene. He's imitating Blades Stanley Kubrick's mannerisms, were. His haircut,
and
his inflection. So he says, are you Spartacus here to free the slaves?
Hey, what you putting your gloves on for, Captain? Your hands cold or something?
Shall we have a little chat?
You got the repeating theme of gloves.
Before
you know, Dr. Slangev, you have the one black glove. You got the boxing gloves. You got the gloves he's putting on here. You got Tony Burton's gloves and the Shining.
Listen.
We see on the counter.
Let's have a game, a little lovely game.
You got the boxer dog. We're boxing. We're stacking things neatly in the West Wing.
Listen. Let's have a game, a little lovely game of Roman ping pong, like two civilized senators.
So Roman ping pong is birthday, date, death day, date, that are the same day.
You're supposed to say Roman pong.
So he gives us Spartacus and Roman ping pong, and he's playing Kubrick, and he's playing a drunk Kubrick in this. And he's pulling balls out of underneath his jacket. He has a never-ending source of balls. So here's Billie Jean King, a tennis player, ball player. King and an ace is 20 or 21. You got Dr. Strangelove, the war room is a circular card table. You got Jamie Lee Curtis, her first movie's Halloween, the first day at the Overlook. There's Rodney Dangerfield in the movie The Killing in the background. There's Scatman Crothers, who dies on Kennedy's death day, November 22nd. So he's a ping pong, or he's a pong pong match with Kennedy. They both die on the same day. There's Huxley. He dies on the same day as Kennedy. Scatman dies on the same day as Kennedy. So he's the ace of spades. He's the jack of spades for 21. There's, is that Burgess? Oh, I'm going to forget to screw this up. Burgess dies on the same day. There's, I'm losing it. There's Berlitz. He dies on the same day. He writes the Philadelphia Experiment. So
slaves
here we have
the movie you were, and slaves you remain, on the single
Douglas,
condition
the
that you identify the body or the living person of the slave called Spartacus.
So there's Woody Strode, the first black professional football player with Neptune Strident in the movie Spartacus. So he's the high jumper. This is our clue to Operation High Jump. He's a cuckoo bird, the first cuckoo bird in One Flew Over the Cuckoo's Nest. He's always got another ball up his sleeve. Just like Kubrick. He's always got another ball he's going to hide in one of his movies.
Roman ping pong.
So this is the ping pong ball.
Kind of tricky serve to handle, eh, Captain? Kind of tricky.
And he calls him Captain because Captains is a category. Yeah, Captain Michael Collins of whiskey.
My mother would be prepared. Say, you Jack Brewster?
Captain Cook. Captain Jack Sparrowson.
What's that?
Captain Mandrake.
Three love. Gee, I'm really winning. You want to get a rally going there.
Captain Kirk.
You know, I'm not accusing you, Captain, but it's sort of absurd the way people invade this house.
Captain
without
Feeney.
Even knocking. 4-1. Change
Captain
service.
America.
I'll take the service again if you don't mind. I sort of like to have it up this end.
You know, Captain Smith of the Titanic.
They use the telephone.
Who died, whose birthday is the day of the Apollo 1 fire?
Jeez. What's that?
Which would be January 27th,
really
which
winning,
would be
man.
Lewis Carroll's
really
birthday.
Winning. I hope I don't get over.
And there we go, he's got another ball up his sleeve.
That's about 6-1, maybe. Let's say 6-1. No, 6-2.
And of course, all the alcohols and liquors and clues, you know, we're always looking
really
for whiskeys and wines and
me,
brandy crater and.
If you haven't noticed how the champs, different champs use their bats.
Moonshine. Moonshots.
Hold him like this and everything.
Jack Daniels.
Do you recall a girl called Dolores Hayes?
I remember one guy, he didn't have a hand. He had a bat instead of a hand. He was a real sort of wacky.
So in ping pong, it's not called a racket. It's a bat. So
Lolita.
Give me the bat, Wendy. Give me the bat.
Yeah. I remember that name, all right. Maybe she made some telephone calls. Who cares?
So he mentions the telephone because it's the Bell telephone is in the puzzle.
Hey, you're a sort of bad loser, Captain. I never found a guy who sort of pull a gun on me when he lost the game. Didn't anyone ever tell you? It's not really who wins, it's how you play, like the champs.
Like the champs.
Didn't anyone ever tell you?
So, in my opinion, Kubrick went out the grand champion. I mean, I don't know how you could have gone out any better.
Listen, I don't
the heavyweight champion.
With
a total knockout. Checkmate. So, you know, Kirk is Spartacus. He's the cuckoo bird. We got Billie Jean King. That's 20. King plus the tennis ace is 21. First movie, Jamie Lee Curtis. Queen of Screams is ever in. Is Halloween, the first day at the Overlook. Johnny Carpenter. One-Eyed Jack. You got Scatman Crothers dies on November 22nd. You got the baseball right behind Danny's head and the phaser toy. You got July 4th, the birthday of your country. And it's a ball, July 4th ball. You got 8-Ball, who's Dorian Harewood, Jungle Bunny. So you got Hare and Bunny. You got One Eyeball. You got Snowball. You got the Jade Rabbit, which is a ball. And you got the Unisphere as a ball. And they blow it up in Men in Black.
1,500 years ago, everybody knew the Earth was the center of the universe. 500 years ago, everybody knew the Earth was flat. 500 years ago, everybody knew the Earth was flat. 500 years ago, everybody knew the Earth was flat. 1,500 years ago, everybody knew the Earth was the center of the universe. 500 years ago, everybody knew the Earth was flat. And 15 minutes ago, you knew that people were alone on this planet.
So there's the Unisphere. We see that at the 1964 World's Fair. It's the Mercator projection. There's Jungle Bunny, Dorian Harewood, and Animal Mother. And he says, thank God for the sickle cell. And he replies to him, yeah, whatever, mother. Whatever, white bread. So there's the blue marbles. There's 8 different kinds of blue marbles. Every blue marble is different. So you don't lose one of them because you lost your marbles. There's the tennis ball. So you get the marble ball, the tennis ball, the ping pong ball. There's Jackie Robinson, the first black professional baseball player. Wins Rookie of the Year at 42. There, give me the bat, Wendy. Give me the bat, Wendy. So there's baseball bat, baseball. We see the baseball glove. We see the bat numerous times during the movie, sitting on couches and there's the fake blue marble. It's a painting. There's a Unisphere at the 1964 World's Fair. This is where we see the moon hardware for the first time. So there's a snowball fight with a subliminal pyramid that's missing in the background. That's the area of the building where the pyramid should have been. There's Danny's tennis ball. He's got the Apollo sweater on. There's the Saturn, planet Saturn. In In the book, it's Saturn. In the movie, it's Jupiter. There's the ridiculous fake crap we believe from NASA. What a joke. So he's number 42, the first black player. And he's a long jumper from UCLA. So you have the slices of oranges. This is a ball. You got the masked ball. You live on a masked ball. It's not a ball. It's a masked ball. So she gets the red ball. She's got a jumpsuit on. She gets the red ball. The writer gets the orange ball. You got Shea Stadium, a ballpark. This is where the Beatles perform after Paul. The first concert after Paul dies. So the fall's first concert is the Shea Stadium. You got ping pong and Lolita, Roman ping pong birthday that day. You got the overlook ball. It's the birthday of your country. It's a ball. You got give me the bat, Wendy. She's got the baseball bat. I got to find out what kind of bat that is. So you got, here's the first three color barrier breakers. So you got Woody Strode, UCLA teammate with Jackie Robinson, and Woody Strode is a high jumper. So we got Bird's Operation High Jump. He carries Neptune's trident because he's such a valuable part of this puzzle. He's one of the central pieces of it. You got Half Man, Half Bull. You got the Minotaur Productions, which is Half Man, Half Bull. This is the Theseus magic thread story. Here we have the Half Man, Half Bull, but it's got the cyclopic eye. So that's the key to Odysseus and the Cyclops story. And Danny walks in his own footprints, just like Theseus and the magic thread. It's Minotaur Productions and A Killer Kiss. There's the Labyrinth. There's Jack in the Labyrinth. He's actually the Minotaur. They're allegorical stories. You're just matching an old, ancient story of Greek allegory, and you're fitting it in. So here's Lou Gehrig, July 4th, the luckiest man in the world. It's, you know, so it's always the luckiest, the fastest, the longest. He goes to Columbia University. You have Kubrick's Columbia University pictorials with Betsy von Furstenberg. There they are. The disc is crashing through the sphere. You got a double eagle in golf. A golf ball is a ball. It's another ball. So you got a double eagle in golf. You got the eagle has landed, Apollo 11, 1-1. You know, aces are 1 or 11. You got a slice in tennis. You got a slice in golf. You've got a slice of the blue marble, a crescent-shaped slice. You have the Clementine mission. You know, Clementine is a fruit. You got the eyeball. It's always changing color. You got the jade rabbit, Luna, the moon, it's a ball. The Unisphere, it's a ball. The two lines around it are the Explorer 1 and Explorer 2 satellites that we launched that never went into space. So, you know, they're hiding the flat Earth right in front of you. Oh, by the way, in that last photograph, if you notice, it's not really the real Unisphere. Because if you look at the thing they're blowing up, there's one continent that's missing off it, and the continent that's missing is Antarctica. So they show you a Unisphere, and the disc crashes through it, but you never notice that there's one continent missing off the model, and it's Antarctica is missing. So, which is bizarre because the real Unisphere in Corona Flushing, Queens, has Antarctica on it. So it's just another little clue there. All right, here we have David Prowse. He's the pro bodybuilder who ends up playing Darth Vader. He's the green crossing guard. He, you know, that's his color, green. And so he's Julian. He plays Julian in Clockwork Orange. We have Tycho Brahe. He loses his nose in a math duel, so he wears a prosthetic nose. He's a redhead. He has a pet elk. Here's another painting of Tycho Brahe. We see the elk in the background. He wears a prosthetic nose. Here's another painting of when he was younger, and his nemesis was essentially Christopher Clavius. So he gets poisoned, Tycho Brahe gets poisoned with mercury, Christopher Clavius and Kepler steal all his information, they create the first Gregorian calendar ever with leap year. So we see the IHS right in the center of this. The Jesuits are all over this. This is Julian Sr., one of Kubrick's inner circle. He talks about how they cut the end of The Shining off, the scene with the snakes and ladders game. Julian Huxley, this would be Aldous Huxley's brother. So you have the Julian calendar. Here's Julian Sr. is the man all the way to the left in this picture. And this is the little picture they did, Staircase to Nowhere. You got Julian Lennon. So a lot of people are using this Julian clue because we used to have the Julian calendar and now we have the Gregorian calendar. So you have Julian, Gregorian, Kubrickian, Jungian. So it's the 29th day of February is what they add. Here's the, you know, he's tied into the IHS. I mean, there's no doubt about it. We're talking about a Jesuit operation. Here's the Tycho magnetic anomaly. They're movie ramps. It's a movie screen. Where the medium is the message. So here's the Clavius base with the clamshell.
What about you?
I'm just on my way up to Clavius.
What about you?
I'm just on my way up to Clavius.
What about you?
I'm just on my way up to Clavius.
Are you? So there's Clavius right here. He's got his little compass right in his hand there. And, you know, so we have the slices again, of course. February 29th is the day they add leap day or leap year, whatever.
Are you sure you won't change your mind about that drink?
Now I'm positive. I really must be going.
Well, I hope that you and your wife can come to the IAC conference in June.
We're going to try. I hope we can make it.
Remember to bring that darling little daughter with you.
Well, that'll all depend on the school vacations and all that sort of thing. But if we can't...
So he mentions vacations, which would be holidays. He mentions his daughter. She wants a Bell video phone for her birthday.
Well, goodbye, Elena.
It's birthdays, holidays.
It's a pleasure meeting you all.
Well, I hope that you and your wife can come to the IAC conference in June.
Well, we're going to try. I hope we can make it.
Remember to bring that darling little daughter with you.
On the holidays. It's going to depend on the holidays, the birthdays.
Don't forget, you got to
red letter days.
No, of course not. Gregory and I will look forward to seeing you.
Well, goodbye, Elena. It's been a pleasure meeting you all.
So the IAC Congress, this is the governing body that names the craters on planets. So if you're Stanley Kubrick and you need to rename some craters during the Apollo missions, the Aldrin, Collins, Armstrong craters, you would have to contact the IAC to make that happen. So Kubrick does just that. He actually renames Moltke Crater. Gets Moltke A, B, and C get renamed Aldrin, Armstrong, and Collins. And of course, so they have an Eagle crater they rename. So the craters that he's renaming are the alchemical, you know, the ones he's inserting him, you know, although some of them are alchemical anyway. Like he chooses landing zones that are alchemical, like the Descartes crater. You know, Descartes is Cartesian geometry. So, and he lands near the Archimedes crater. So that would be, you know, water finds its level. So, I mean, the clues are everywhere. So there's Tycho. He's a redhead. He lost his nose in a duel. And he says the stars show no apparent parallax over long periods of time. Tycho murders him with Mercury and steals all his work. And he creates the first Gregorian calendar. So you have Gregorian. Julian is the calendar before Gregorian. Here's the slices in the Clavius base. So Clavius was a baller, there's no doubt. And Tycho was a monolither.
This thing turns out to be half as I thought.
Another reference to half, you know, it's a 1964 and a half Mustang. Half man, half
promotion. Personal citations over this thing's over with. That goes back, regardless of your color or your creed.
The message here is it's one human race, and we need to get that message because we're not getting it right now. And that's it, guys. I had a lot of fun doing this. I hope that you enjoy it. If you liked it, you learned something, if you thought it was funny or whatever, thumb it up because I really don't make anything off this. I do it because I like to do it. And good night. Bye.
All communications are dead.
Oh.
To call it shiny.